Good morning, students. Now I am teaching to you 10th class first chapter real numbers first exercise 5th problem. What is the question, ma'am? Show that one and only out of n plus 2 or n plus 4 is divisible by 3 where n is any natural number. Okay, so what the meaning is? In these three numbers, any one is divisible by 3. Okay, how you can prove? By using Euclid division lemma. Okay, so let us take A is any positive integer. Here, show that one and only out of n plus 2 or n plus 4 is divisible by 3. That means here, what is the divisor here? 3. Okay, so b is equal to 3 by using Euclid division lemma. Okay, so what the Euclid division lemma? Dividend is equal divisor into quotient plus remainder. What are the conditions of remainder? It is greater than or equal to 0 and less than divisor. Okay, so 0 less than or equal or less than b. Here, what the b divisor? 3. Why we can take the b is 3? Because they given that it is divisible by 3. That means the divisor is how much? 3. That means the remainder is how much? 0. Here we want to prove that any one of the number is divisible by 3. That means when it is divided by 3, the remainder is 0. Okay, so here 0 less than or equal or less than 3. So now what are the values of remainder here? 0, 1, 2. Here what the condition? It is greater than or equal to 0 and less than 3. Okay, so the values are 0, 1, 2, 3. A is equal 3 into q plus r. Okay, so if r is equal to 0, then a is equal to 3q. If r is equal to 1, then a is equal to 3q plus 1. If r is equal to 2, then a is equal to 3q plus 2. Okay, now next case 1. Here, how many numbers are given? 3 numbers are we can get. What are they? A is equal to 3 cube, A is equal to 3 cube plus 1, A is equal to 3 cube plus 2. Okay, so in this, any one of number is divisible by 3. So let us take case 1. Here, n is equal to 3 cube. Okay, that means what? N is equal to 3 cube means what? 3 into cube. That means n is a multiple of 3. So multiple is nothing but divisible. So here, therefore, n is divisible by 3. Okay, next n plus 2. Here n is the what? 3 cube. So that is 3 cube plus 2. That means this number is divided by 3. The remainder is how much? 2 more. So therefore, this number is not divisible by 3. So therefore, n plus 2 is not divisible by 3. Next, n plus 4. Here, that is what the n value? 3 cube. 3 cube plus 4. Here also same. This number is divided by 3. The remainder is 4. So therefore, n plus 4 is not divisible by 3. Okay, next case 2. So first number I want to go 3 cube. In 3 cube, n is equal to 3 cube is divisible by 3. Next, second case, n is equal to 3 cube plus 1. Here, this number is divided by 3. The remainder is 1. So therefore, this number is not divisible by 3. So therefore, n is not divisible by 3. Why? It is divided by 3. The remainder is 1. Okay? So, what is n? 3 cube plus 1. 3 cube plus 1 plus 2. That is 3 cube plus 1 plus 2 ma 3. Okay. 3 cube plus 3 ma. So 3 is taking outside 3 cube, 3 into cube. Here 3. Of cube plus 1. So n plus 2 ma. So therefore n plus 2 is multiples of 3. The multiples of 3 is nothing but divisible by 3. So therefore n plus 2 is divisible by 3. Next n plus 4. That is equal what the n ma? 3 cube plus 1 plus 4. That is equal 3 cube plus 5. So therefore here the n plus 4 is divided by 3, the remainder is 5. So therefore n plus 4 is not divisible by 3. Next case 3, n is equal to 3 cube plus 2. Here it is divided by 3, the remainder is 2. So therefore n is not divisible by 3. Next n plus 1. So that is n plus 2. That is 3 cube plus 2 plus 2. That is 3 cube plus 2 plus 2. 4. So the n plus 2 is divided by 3. The remainder is 4. So therefore n plus 2 is not divisible by 3. Next n plus 4. So what the n mark? 3 cube plus 2. So 3 cube plus 2 plus 4, that is equal 3 cube plus 2 plus 4, 6. Here 3 cube plus 6, 6 how to get that? 3 2, so in this 2 are the common 3, so 3 of cube plus 2. So that means the n plus 4 is multiples of 3. This multiples of 3 is nothing but divisible by 3. So therefore n plus 4 is divisible by 3. Example 4 ma. Consider the number 4 power n. Okay. Example 3 ma. Consider the number 4 power n, where n is a natural number. Check whether there is any value of n for which 4 power n ends with a digit 0. Okay. So if any number is n with a digit 0, that means it is divisible by 10 or it is divisible by 2 and 5. Okay, divisible is nothing but multiples. Multiples of 10 or multiples of 2 and 5. That means the number its prime factorization is in the form of 2 and 5. Okay, prime factorization means any number can be expressed as product of power of prime numbers. Okay, this prime factorization another name is fundamental theorem of arithmetic. Okay, so here what the given number 4 power n. So the 4 power n for any natural number, that means n is belongs to n. Okay, if n is equal to 1, the 4 power n value 4 power 1 is equal to 4. N is equal to 4 square is equal to 16. N is equal to 3, 4 cube is equal to 64. N is equal to 4, 4 power 4 is equal to 56. So it is n with the digit is 4 6 4 6, it is continuum. Okay, let 4 6. Okay, its prime factorization is 2 into 2. Its prime factorization is in the form of 2. Okay, so if it is n with the digit 0, its prime factorization is 2 and 5, but it is impossible. Okay, so here the number 4 power n is n with digit either 4 or 6. 4 or 6. Okay. If it is n with the digit 0, with digit 0 is 0, its prime factorization is 2 power n into 5 power n, but it is impossible because
because the prime factorization of four power n is 2 square 1 power n is equal to 2 power 2 n. Okay, this is the proof. Example format: find the LCM and LCM of 12 and 18 by the prime factorization method. Prime factorization method means what now? Any composite number can be expressed as product of power of prime numbers. This prime factorization method, another name is fundamental theorem of arithmetic. Okay, so here what the question? Find the HCF. HCF means highest common factor, and LCM means least common multiple of 12 and 18 by the prime factorization method. First, the given numbers write as prime factorization method. So, prime factorization, how to get right? The number can be write as product of power of prime numbers. Okay, so here, 12. Given numbers. What are the given numbers? 12 and 18. So, 12 we can write as product of power of prime numbers. So, how to get right as product? Here there is two methods are there. One is division method. Division method means the number can divide with prime numbers. Next, another method is tree method. Okay, so 12 2 6 2 3 3 1. So now write as product of dividers 2 into 2 into 3. Okay, so next 18 2 9 3 3 3 1. So that is 2 into 3 into 3. Okay, so how we can find LCM in prime factorization method? Okay, how we can take means, take the least common multiple factors. Okay, in these two, how many factors are there? 2. What are there? 2 and 3. Here 2 is multiple how many times? 2 times. Here 1 time. Here 3 is multiple how many times? 2 times. Here 3 is multiple how many times? 1 time. So what the least? 1 time of 2, 1 time of 3. So that is LCM of 12 and 18 is equal least common multiple factors. So that is 2 into 3. Okay. Next, LCM of 12 and 18. How we can take LCM in prime factorization method? Means here, how we can take LCM, how we can take the least common multiple factor? LCM, how we can take just reverse? That is, highest multiple of all factors. Here, 2 is multiple how many times? 2 times. 3 is multiple how many times? 2 times. That is, 2 into 2. Highest multiple of all factors. Ikkada ma, least multiple of common factor. Ikkada, highest multiple of all factors. So, 2, 3 ja 6. Here, 2 ja 4. 4, 3 ja 12. 1, 3 ja 13. So, LCM of 12 and 18 is 6, LCM of 12 and 18 is 36.